make of the session in the end?
Not a bad session for the Australian share market by the end of the day. We were down by 0.2%, but intraday we were down as much as 1% during the session, and some strong volumes going through as well, with $4.9 billion worth of stock being traded. Of course, here in Australia, one of the central themes was earnings season, and we saw some big names coming out today. Telstra coming out with its result, it was down by 2% in terms of stock price performance, so it was a drag on the market. But News Corp really impressing with its second quarter result, that stock up by 0.9%, and of course we're waiting on Rio Tinto, but that stock only down by 0.2%. In the material space, we still saw BHP Billiton, a drag, down by 1.6%, but also still in that material space, and there were some big movers today as well. We saw Sandfire, Link Energy up more than 5% today, and of course the other thing that the market was focused on were the China inflation numbers, which were out at 12:30. If I can point to an intraday chart of the Australian market, 12:30, when those numbers came out, we'd saw the market bottoming out, but you can see that once those numbers were released, the market really just moved on, and the market now looking towards Greece and hopefully a deal being signed in the next 24 hours. And you can see in the afternoon we saw again not only in the Aussie share market but also in the Aussie dollar, and you can see from 3 p.m. we really saw it climbing in the Aussie dollar back above 108 US cents.
Michael, we're going to talk about the chain corporate earnings out today a little bit later in the show. Before we do that, Julie, I want to get your thoughts on Sims. Earnings downgrade, they got smashed.
They got absolutely smashed today. The shares were down by around about 7%. And if we have a look at Sims, they are the largest recycler of iron as well as steel. And if we have a look at its business, it's mostly outside of Australia. More than 70% of its earnings comes from offshore, and about 50% of its earnings comes from the US. Of course, if we have a look at the US assets, a lot of them were bought before the global financial crisis. So given the environment that has deteriorated in terms of asset valuations over the last 4 years, not so surprising to see Sims coming out with a pretty big write-down, $614 million to its North American business. But also, if we have a look at profit expectations, expecting underlying profit to be quite flat. So it has been a difficult environment for Sims over the last couple of years. But really, the purchase of their businesses just before the global financial crisis and just before we saw asset values deteriorating, seeing that big write-down, unfortunately, shareholders won't be too happy today with the shares down by about 7%.
So not a surprise for you, Julie, because we've had a few people over the last 18 months or so and say, look, they like Sims. You know, they like the area that they're in. They like the positioning within that that market as well. But as you say, it's been a tough time.
I think Sims is undergoing a little bit of a transformation. Typically, a lot of its earnings came from North America, and this is an area that has been quite sluggish in terms of its recovery, and that's been quite hard for Sims. But if we have a look at what it's done over the last few months, it's really been diversifying its business and trying to break into the Chinese market. And we saw that with the purchase of the Hong Kong Chinese metal recycler CTG last month. And so we are going to see a key market, I think, opening up for Sims, and China really offering some potential growth there. But the North American recovery being so sluggish has been quite a drag on its business, and I think it has been a difficult time for Sims. Hopefully the change in its business model, moving away from North America and more into Asia, will help its business. Because if we have a look at where steel and iron ore demand comes from, it does come from construction and mainly the urbanization of countries like China and India.